Welcome to tonight's game. It promises to be a good one between the Kentucky Wildcats and the Missouri Tigers. And here we have our two players who are the focus of ours. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here we go. After all the anticipation, we're underway. The Wildcats are currently ranked number 22 in the country, Dick.
I'm sure they're happy that they are amongst the top teams in the nation, but they better respond to the challenge. A little off-ball action happening.
They're working around the perimeter. He blocks the shot. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Swatted away. Noel handles the feed. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessel. Nice to have you along with us. Number 11 makes his first substitution.
I'll tell you what I like about him, Brad. He brings all kinds of energy to the floor.
Loose ball. Great play. For the bucket, he buries it.
Look at that. That's unbelievable, baby.
They set up into a box formation. And a momentary look from three-point land. With the jumper. Nope. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Aaron.
Well, guys, it's obvious the coaching staff wants the team to slow it down. The tempo is definitely not where they want it. The players have been instructed to run the shot clock offensively and force the opposition to play defense for extended periods of time.
EA, of course, our third member, getting that additional insight and dealings from the sideline. This is what he's been able to bring to the court per game so far this season.
One thing that stats don't show, Brad, are the intangibles. The pass that leads to the pass that ultimately leads to a score. Deflections, diving for loose balls. Those are all the important stats in my books.
It looks like a few substitutions are going to be made here. Goes up for two. Great shot. A great drive to the hoop right there, Dick.
He has all kinds of moves, and we saw just about all of them on that drive. A good-looking two-point.
Number 33 handles the feed.
Look at that spacing.
And it's heading out of bounds. No, great save. Number 5 looks to record his first miss.
He provides nice push offensively and defensively for this buck.
To shoot. They work the perimeter. Let's it fly.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Looking for a good shot.
The athleticism in some of these kids, Brad, I'll tell you, it's incredible. Trying to make a hard cut to get open there.
5 minutes left in the game clock. Cross court. He shoots from the deep corner. Scorches the net with a J.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Pushing in transition. Cross court. Or two with the block. Here they are on the break. Trying to pack it inside. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Dick, are they being taken out of their game offensively?
Hey, they're taking themselves out of the game by rushing bad shots and not executing an offense.
on the right side. The Wildcats have a great freshman class. They've definitely got some kids with potential. From the top of the key and off the mark. And the slam. Some subs get ready to check in. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Cross court. For the bucket. Off the mark. A little two-man action. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
That's a great indication of how frantic the pace has been, Brad.
Number 12 pops back into the ballgame after a well-deserved rest.
Wow, he makes such an impact on his team when he's in the game. At both ends of the court, Brad. Concentrate. Got to concentrate on that free throw line.
It's his second. 3 minutes left on the game clock.
Gotta think right now. Gotta focus defensively.
He tries the jumper. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
Dick, they go into their offensive set, and this one looks like you could take it back to grade school.
Well, you know, it's a box set right now, and what they're trying to do is get some isolations for players individually to take advantage of their great skills.
They work it around the perimeter. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Number 15 is whistled for the foul. Second team foul. Sideline inbounds. Great block shot. Ball's going to stay here. This one will come in from the baseline. From the corner. About 2 minutes remaining.
Another brick, baby. Building a new arena.
Kicks it out. They're set to inbounds from the baseline. Loose ball and batted in. And the ball out of bounds, but we'll be staying right here. Cross court. Number 15 picks up the foul. Third team foul. And, of course, his season average.
It's not always about numbers, Brad. It's good to fill the stat sheet. But does he do the little things? That's the question.
He got it. It's two at the charity stripe. Number four takes the feed.
Up and inside.
Number 15 is called for the foul. He'll go to the line. First shot, no good. The shooting guard takes the pass on the outside. 1 minute left on the game clock.
Silly mistake. 2-for-1 opportunity. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Young man looking to get open on the perimeter.
On the right side. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. And it's knocked loose. Shot clock is dead. For two, makes the shot. Back on offense now. Now they work it around the perimeter. Jumper won't go. Pull up jumper from way out. No good. The Wildcats are up by one. Kentucky gave a great rebounding performance in the first half of this one, partner.
I'll tell you, great effort and great poise. That's a sign of a championship team, if you ask me.
Looks like they're going to go with a full court man-to-man press, Dick. On the left side. Moving it around the perimeter. There's the rejection.
Oh, what a great job transition. Offense. Poor job defensively. Don't get back. Don't stop the ball. And they're allowed to convert. Get the number game going.
On the outside. Struggling from trifecta land so far.
Yeah, they're having serious trouble hitting the shot tonight, Brad. That's surprising for this team. Coach about to adjust his rotation.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
10 to shoot. Goodwin receives the pass. From beyond the arc. Poor decision. He has no business taking that shot.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
Splits a double team. On the dribble, gives it up. The Wildcats in transition. He hammers it home. That's a momentum buster.
He's here to fight, baby.
Tries for two. That one's off. Substitutions forthcoming. Fast break possibility coming. For the bucket, he gets the shot to fall. About 6 minutes remaining. Gave it up. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
Tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Goes up for two. Buried it. Three-point range. That's not a good shot given his abilities.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
He shoots from the corner. Knocks it down. Looking to move it around the perimeter. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. Number 11 is charged with the foul. Number 22 makes his debut into the game.
I tell you, this kid comes in with fire, Brad. He really knows how to bring it.
Chance for an easy one. misses the first.
Coach about to juggle the lineup.
He hits the second shot. Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Out on the wing. Launches the three.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
They go into the low block. In the lane. Off the mark. For two. Knocks it down. 4 minutes left on the game clock. Working it around the perimeter. And the ball is saved. Great job. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Here comes the ball screen. Shoots from outside. Gets the J to fall. Finds himself back out on the court.
This team plays a lot differently when he's in the game, Brad.
Is that good or bad, Dickie?
I think they play a lot more under control.
Number 11 takes it away. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, it's quite obvious that the coaching staff wants their team to slow down the tempo. I can hear him on the sideline talking to his bench players about being patient and running sets. He wants the defense to break down first before settling for a shot. Unless, of course, it's a layup. Guys?
Aaron Andrews, our sideline correspondent, as usual, providing that extra bit of insight. Cross court. He goes for three. Can't connect. On the right side. From the corner. Busts the jumper. The Wildcats are going to have to make some modifications here, Dick. They're going to have to throw out the idea of playing in the half court and get this into more of an up-tempo game.
Since time and score is not in their favor, they're going to have to change their style. They need points, and they need them fast. I anticipate some sort of adjustment around.
Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right times.
On the left side, he throws it up from downtown. Busts the J. Two minutes left on the game clock. Cross court. Whistle and foul. Coach not happy in the sideline. Steps to the line for the freebie. Sinks it. Well, he's just a freshman, but hey, we all got to start somewhere.
Well, Brad, it's a lot different from his high school days. This is a big business now. It's about maturing and ensuring that he gets better every day and develops into a great all-around student athlete.
Goes up for two. The layup is good. Looking for a good shot. And we got a whistle and a foul. He'll visit the charity stripe. First one is no good, and they can't find the rhythm at the line.
I see a lot of them rushing their shots, Brad.
second shot is good. Throws it up. Setting up offensively. Now trying to feed the low block. One minute left on the game clock. Blocks the shot. Number 32, subpar performance is just destroying his confidence.
Things aren't coming easy for him right now. He's in a rut.
Cross court. He looks for three. He misses the jumper. Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? Foul, and that stops the clock again. The offense sets up from the sideline. And the clock stopped with a foul. The offense begins off the sideline inbounds. They've got a player spotting up on the three. Foul, and that stops the clock again. And the clock stopped with a foul.
Coach looking to change his lineup.
Makes the foul shot. His second shot. He unloads a three. And Dick, the shooting woes continue from behind the arc.
Hey, that's a couple in a row now where they've come up empty. Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
I think they're trying to make a statement. Number 33 going to the line for the first time tonight. Misses the front end of the 1-1. He attempts the jump shot. They get it to go. The Tigers finally ending the losing streak.
Hey, it's always tough to come into a game riding a losing streak, but they no longer have to worry about that. Now they must continue to do the things which put them in position to win this game.
Kentucky fought the good fight, but they still come up short.
This is the type of game that the coaching staff will be studying for weeks to come.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.